In the first half century of Darwinian evolution, the theory was completely dependent on fraudulent evidence for its support. When they mandated Darwinian evolution to be taught in the public schools, there was, in reality, no convincing evidence to support the theory. They were, in fact, using frauds to brainwash children into what was, in reality, a new atheist religion based on fiction. In his book, The Icons of Evolution, biologist Jonathan Wells lays out what he calls the icons of evolution. What he could have named the book is The Frauds of Evolution. I'm going to mention only a couple of those examples. I'm going to give you much more. I'll leave it to you to refer to his work for things like the fraudulent Miller-Urey experiment and so forth. I'm going to explain why the theory is still being supported by fraudulent evidence to this very day, and why you should suspect any evidence presented to the public as being fraudulent. So let's go to example one, Haeckel's embryo fraud. This is one of the examples that is presented by Jonathan Wells in his book, Icons of Evolution. Used for decades in high school and college biology textbooks, Haeckel's embryo drawings were intentionally fraudulent to make the theory more believable. And the drawings were even known to be fraudulent, and they continued to use them. There are even textbooks that will still use them to this day. But in reality, the drawings are completely fraudulent. Number two, Piltdown Man. This is one of my favorites because this fooled scientists for decades. Piltdown Man was a human evolution fraud. For 40 years, Piltdown Man was regarded as absolute proof of human evolution. There were hundreds of doctoral theses written supporting this hoax. That's right, scientists really believed in Piltdown Man. But Piltdown Man was exposed as a fraud. The jawbone and teeth were from an orangutan. The teeth had been filed down to make them look human. The bones and teeth had been chemically treated to look old. This was a outright calculated fraud. And they taught this to school children for years. Many school children just believe this because this is what they were taught. School teachers believe this. This is what was in the textbooks. But that wasn't the end of it. There's much, much more. Number three, the Nebraska Man fraud. The discovery of Nebraska Man was such compelling evidence for the evolution. That is why they mandated it be taught to children in schools. But the fossil was constructed from a single tooth that turned out to be from an extinct species of pig, which was later found to still be alive. So that should give you some idea of the competency and integrity of the people forwarding Darwinian theory. There is no nonsense too big for them to feed to your children and to brainwash you with. Number four, Java Man fraud. This fossil was found by a student of Ernst Haeckel, the man who gave us the embryo drawing fraud. Java Man was constructed from a human skull cap that was taken from a native gravesite on Java Island. The student knew it was a fraud because he had two other human skull caps from the same location he hid for years. So student like teacher, Haeckel must have taught him well. Number five, Neanderthal Man. Announced as a vital missing link between humans and earlier hominids. But quote, detailed comparisons of Neanderthal skeletal remains and those of modern humans have shown there is nothing in Neanderthal anatomy that conclusively indicates locomotor, manipulative, intellectual, or linguistic abilities inferior to those of modern humans. Quote from Harding Luke 2005, Another Day, Another Science Fraud. Anthropologist Resigns in Dating Disaster 2005, World Net Daily. So basically, human anatomy has great variance. We have very small people in the pygmy tribe, and then we have basketball players who are almost 8 feet tall. So differences in human anatomy are not evidence for evolution and only confirms things that we already know. Number six, Lucy the Ape. Lucy is just the newer, more sophisticated Piltdown Man fraud. Although publicly exposed as a fraud, they still hang on to this one. A collection of bone fragments with the bone vertebra of a baboon having been found in the mix. The Lucy reconstruction contains the upper skull based on modern chimps, combined with human-like teeth and jaws. So this is really just Piltdown Man in reverse. Instead of a human skull with an ape jaw, we have an ape skull with a human jaw. Number 7, Orseman. This missing link was exposed in 1984 as a skull of a 4-month-old donkey. They just can't get enough of these hoaxes. They broadcast these frauds loudly in the media and then quietly make their corrections in the back of scientific journals. So this is all for public consumption. You need to understand this about the Darwinian theory paradigm. Number 8, Archaeoraptor. I'm not sure if I'm saying that right, but it's a fictional animal and therefore it's a fictional name. First considered to be the missing link between dinosaurs and birds, this hoax was produced by a farmer in China using two different fossils glued together. In 1997, National Geographic published this as the true missing link. It wasn't until 2000 that scientists realized it was a hoax. They said they were too busy to study it. A true missing link, they were too busy to study. But notice they weren't too busy to publish it as the true missing link. Number 9, horse evolution fraud. The clay depicting horse evolution was known to be false for decades, but it still ended up in high school and university textbooks. Dr. Niles Eldridge, the curator of the American Museum of Natural History, states, "I admit that an awful lot of that has gotten into textbooks as though it were true. For instance, the most famous example still on exhibit downstairs in the American Museum is the exhibit of horse evolution prepared perhaps 50 years ago. That has been presented as literal truth in textbook after textbook. Now I think that is lamentable." So in other words, Dr. Eldridge knew that the horse evolution depiction was a fraud, and yet it was still on display at the museum. This is how evolution works. These things are taught in public schools and at university as fact, and yet they are known frauds by the scientists themselves. Number 10, and I love this one, the missing link, Ida. In May of 2009, the discovery of the Ida fossil was hailed as the missing link in human evolution. Ida was broadcast in a media frenzy. Books, websites, videos were all abuzz over the new discovery. They claim this fossil was part of our evolution. And while Ida is a very nice fossil, in reality, she is nothing more than an extinct species of lemur, nothing more. Even in Darwinian terms, there is nothing that indicates Ida could even possibly be part of a human evolutionary chain. The fossil was found in rock layers that in evolutionary terms are much younger than known fossils of other more advanced primates, including other lemurs. But of course, these facts only come out after the media frenzy, Darwinian propaganda is over. And number 11, Darwin's finches. And this one's great because this is what kicked off the entire speculation that all life could begin by random changes, random variations, and natural selection. But now after, you know, almost two centuries of observing these birds, what we see is that the changes in beak sizes just keeps going in circles. It's not going anywhere. The birds are not evolving into anything more than what they are. They're not gaining further complexity. And so Darwin's mechanism has no evidence that it can produce complex integrated systems like you would see in, say, a heart-lung system or things that require forethought. So we know that Darwin's mechanism doesn't work. It doesn't logically work for the purpose of creating complex integrated systems. A favorite example, evolutionists like Dawkins like to say, an eye would be easy to evolve. All you need is a little indentation and a pinhole camera and you can get eyes. That's completely ignoring the fact that the complex part of an eye is the visual cortex in your brain. And we haven't the foggiest idea how this immensely complex part of our brain works. It's designed specifically for deciphering visual coding and then somehow transmitting it to our consciousness so we see beautiful colors and images. So Darwinian evolution is either just wishful thinking or not thinking the problem through before they start talking about it. So while I could go on with more of these examples, in conclusion, evolution was supported by frauds from the very beginning, and is still supported by frauds to this very day. Lucy, Ida, and horse evolution are prime examples. They simply keep replacing the old frauds with the new and better frauds, such as they still maintain the Lucy fraud even though it's been outed as a fraud for many years now. So when people tell me, "Look at the evidence," I reply, "I have, and there's one thing that is certain. There is a consistent group of people who are pathological liars supporting Darwinian evolution. They are proven liars. Why should I believe anything they say on this topic? So unless I can independently verify whatever new evidence comes out, I have to assume that more than likely it's fraudulent than not. All the biggest discoveries in evolution were frauds. So considering the long history of fraud supporting Darwinian evolution, it is only logical to first assume that whatever they are presenting is more of the same. You have to always, always remember it takes sometimes decades for other scientists to uncover these frauds and expose them. This includes the so-called DNA evidence and all these other things. You can know with absolute certainty that there is statistical cherry-picking going on to put a shine on this theory. In the past, we know for certain that people believed evolution based on fraud after fraud, and there was really no substance to the theory at all without the frauds. So with this long, well-documented history of fraud supporting Darwinian evolution, you must always remember that the burden of proof is on those advancing the theory to show us that they are not presenting us with more frauds. Always remember, they fool PhD scientists for decades with these frauds. So, personally, I have no reason to trust anything from the people who are advancing this theory. And you have no reason to trust them either. So, I hope that you've enjoyed this presentation and you've learned something new. And especially, I hope that you will be more critical-minded when it comes to the theory of Darwinian evolution. And we're going to discuss more of that shortly. Thanks for watching.